When it comes to water quality, farms get a lot of the focus, but urban areas contribute their fair share of water pollutants too. All the puzzle pieces are in play. Uses, practices, pollutants, sources, hydrology, this piece of the puzzle is easiest to identify in an urban setting. The shift from grassy natural areas to pavement and asphalt everywhere. Urban resource conservationist Wayne Peterson says that this is one piece of the puzzle we can affect dramatically by employing green development.
The definition of green development that I like to use is development that does not create or add negative environmental impacts. I believe that we will see designs of new development start to incorporate more focus on how are we going to manage water and how is water going to move off of this landscape in a post-development setting.
Peterson envisions a return to a more natural hydrology for urban areas.
Having water moving through the system properly in a sustainable way is kind of the foundation of an ecosystem. And if you've got a bad foundation on a building, it's probably gonna crumple over time. And if you don't manage water properly, which is the foundation of the ecosystem, I believe all other aspects of that ecosystem will tend to unravel. I know we're not going to turn the whole world back into prairie, of course, but I do think we can understand how water might once have moved through this natural or native ecosystem. And I think we can design new developments that will mimic the way that landscape functioned, even if it doesn't look like it once did.